Stacy Keibler here tonight. Kicking things off with cruiserweight action.
Following cruiserweight matches scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring for Japan, weighing in at 206 pounds, Tajiri.
What about Tajiri's actions last week on SmackDown? Tajiri wouldn't allow her to shed her clothes. He covered her up in the middle of the ring.
And, well, he should have. Would you allow your wife to do that?
Well, I don't think Tori's his girlfriend anymore.
Weighing in at 215 pounds, Billy Kidman.
Well, I cannot wait for this matchup. It's Billy Kidman and Tajiri right here on Velocity. Cruiserweights in action. And, folks, this is a brand new show here on TNN. Your opportunity to see stars from the SmackDown brand go one-on-one here tonight. And I cannot wait. Women's title on the line. Bra and panty style, Trish and Stacy.
I can't wait either.
Plus, your buddy Hardcore Holly's in action against the Big Valbowski. And we'll take a look back to this past Thursday night on SmackDown and the retirement that wasn't for Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
I'm just happy to be here with you, Michael, on this brand new show. Are you missing your Thursday friend?
Taz?
Yeah.
Well, nonetheless, Saturday night here on the new TNN as Tajiri starts things off against Billy Kidman.
I guess you could call me Mr. Saturday Night.
Tremendous rivalry out between these two superstars. These two men have exchanged the Cruiserweight Championship over the past month or so. And I'll tell you, two contrasting styles despite the fact that they are both cruiserweights.
And they've had, not just over the past month, but a longer history than that, back in WCW over that same title, the Cruiserweight title then.
Cruiserweight champion now is, of course, the Hurricane, who defeated both Tajiri and Billy Kidman in a triple threat match just a couple of weeks ago on SmackDown. And this is a unique move by Tajiri.
Watch how he hooks the leg over the head, hooks Billy Kidman's leg over his, and literally just tries to cut the wind off by stretching.
And the Hurricane, he's been having some problems as of late as well. I guess you would call it a stalker, leaving notes all around the locker room area for the Hurricane. The latest note had something to do with beef jerky and, well, the person stalking the Hurricane not being fat.
And not being tall. It kind of led me to believe it might have been your broadcast partner.
Who, Taz?
Yes.
Oh, will you stop as Kidman now goes to work on that left arm of Tajiri. Tajiri with the reversal and takes Billy Kidman down. The Japanese buzzsaw Tajiri, an accomplished cruiserweight, but he is a world-renowned star out.
Yes, without a doubt. You know, though, thank God, back to the Hurricane, though, thank God he has a friend like Gregory Helms on the case.
Yeah, his reporter friend, Gregory Helms.
Yes, ace reporter.
Whatever. The Cruiserweight division exclusive to Mr. McMahon. SmackDown to Tajiri, Billy Kidman, the Hurricane, among others, participating in this division. And Kidman looks to take control of Tajiri.
And I love the Cruiserweight division.
What do you think? Oh, look at this. Here
with
the cover. Off the suplex is Billy Kidman and a kick out by Tajiri. I'm interested to know what Tajiri, Al, thought about what happened at Judgment Day this past Sunday. His ex-girlfriend, Tori, out on a date with, your buddy from Tough Enough, Maven.
That's my boy. He learns well.
Maven claiming that bald is beautiful. And he's got a point there. He's out with Tori.
Apparently, Tori thinks bald is beautiful.
And Kidman taking Tajiri down. And Tajiri in a world of trouble here as we kick off this brand new show, Velocity, here on the new TNN. And, oh, what an arm drag takedown by Billy Kidman. Up over the top in the Hurricane Rana to Tajiri. And Tajiri needs a breather. He needs a timeout in this cruiserweight matchup.
Where's Billy Kidman going?
The high flyer, Billy Kidman, former cruiserweight champion. And
Tajiri took a walk.
And look at Billy Kidman with a baseball slide. Knocks Tajiri into the table at ringside.
Careful, guys.
And Billy Kidman taking control of Tajiri. The winner of this matchup would put themselves right back toward the number one contender spot for the cruiserweight title, now held by the Hurricane.
Hey, you know, neither one of these guys are really kind of tall, are they?
Kidman and Tajiri?
Right.
No, they're cruiserweights. Look at Billy up over the top and dropping that leg on the sternum. Hook of the leg of Tajiri and a kick out just before the count of three.
Well, I'm just trying to figure out the clues, you know, help Hurricane out.
What an exciting matchup. You were talking about Tori earlier on. I wonder what she thinks about the big bra and panties match for the women's title here tonight on Velocity between Trish and Stacy.
Well, hopefully she's thinking of getting involved.
Oh, what a shot to the temple! Control. cruiserweight matchup. Welcome back to Velocity, everybody. Michael Cole and Al Snow, and this is what happened during the break of this cruiserweight matchup. Tajiri taking control after the shot to the temple as he shot Billy Kidman into that steel post. And during the breakout, Tajiri actually went outside the ring to break up the referee's count and get Kidman back into the ring.
Well, I know that. I was sitting right here with you watching it.
And this crowd is getting all over the Japanese buzzsaw, Tajiri. Oh, and a shot to the solar plexus. It is so great to be here on TNN with Mr. McMahon's SmackDown on this brand new show, Velocity. And it's going to be great to see Mean Gene Okerlund back. Coming up after Velocity, it's WWE Confidential. Oh, that's going to be a lot of fun. Some behind-the-scenes look at what happened at Survivor Series a few years ago with Bret Hart and Shawn Michaels.
I am definitely interested in hearing Shawn Michaels' side of it. We have heard Bret Hart's side of it over and over again. It'll be good to hear the other side of the coin.
Hey, look at Tajiri continuing the pressure on that left arm and shoulder that Billy Kidman went into that steel post with, and Kidman trying to battle back, building up momentum in this matchup. Shot to the side of the head of Tajiri. Great counter by Kidman. Lands on his feet. Another shot by Tajiri. And another one.
He's kicking him in the arm. He's going right back to the focus of the injury. You take a point of balance away, that's how you beat a man, and that's exactly what Tajiri's doing.
The quick kicks, you could hear them echoing throughout this arena to the arm of Billy Kidman. And Tajiri may rip that arm out of socket as Kidman lands center of the ring.
Going right back to it, staying focused, using an actual strategy to try and defeat Billy Kidman.
What the hell is this?
A form of a surfboard where he's also still got the arm practically in a hammerlock with his own leg.
Well, Tajiri had his shoulders on the mat and almost got counted out three by referee Mike Sparks. And again, he begins the attack on the left arm of Billy Kidman.
Well, speaking of Tajiri and his old girlfriend, Tori, talked about Tori finding maidens. Bald is beautiful, right?
Right, well, that's what we think. We're not quite sure what the relationship is right now.
Do you think she'd find Angle if he's beautiful? Do you think he'd be beautiful now that he's bald?
How ridiculous is Kurt Angle? He loses a hair versus hair match at Judgment Day to Edge. He gets his head shaved at Judgment Day in Nashville by Edge. He's supposed to show up on SmackDown with no hair. What does he do? Ridiculous wig and headgear. Oh, look at the cross body. One, the cover. Two, and Tajiri bridged out of it. Ooh. And a shot to the temple. And another one. Wow. Oh. And a shot to the head by Tajiri.
Can Kidman take much more?
Hook of the leg. Tajiri and Kidman again gets the shoulder up. The resilience of these cruiserweights. I don't think Tajiri can believe that Kidman is somehow getting out of these pinning predicaments.
A lot of heart, a lot of desire. That's what's causing Kidman to pick himself up off that mat.
And look at him. This guy's a moron. And I'll tell you what, no wonder Tori left him. The guy had Tori, his girlfriend, dressed up in a geisha outfit, embarrassing and humiliating her for weeks.
Excuse me, I don't necessarily agree with what he did, but that doesn't make him a moron. That makes him from a different culture, a different society. That is how Japanese people have learned to treat their women.
But Tori didn't look like she wanted to be treated that way.
Well, I didn't want her to be treated that way either. I'd like her out of the geisha outfit, too.
Oh, well, she got out of the relationship, not only the geisha outfit. And look at Billy Kidman, went for the backslide. Tajiri countered, and again, torquing that left arm. Tajiri could be causing some serious damage, maybe even long-term damage, to the arm of Kidman here, Al.
He is doing exactly what he needs to do. Stay focused. Take that point of balance away. You break down one part of the body, you break down it all.
You talk about staying focused. I'm going to be real focused here a little bit later on. Stacy, Trish, bra and panties match for the women's title. A match set up by Mr. McMahon, and there's a unique story there, which we'll get into in just a few moments. And Tajiri with a chop to the chest of Billy Kidman. Tajiri has controlled this matchup almost from the onset. Kidman looked to reverse it, and here comes the tarantula, and Kidman somehow countered.
Thank goodness. Oh, and right back to the arm.
Well, that's why Tajiri is so good in the ring, Al. He has such a good concept of where his opponent is at all times. Nobody home. Kidman rolling out of the way. And this could be the opening Kidman needs.
Up and over springboard moonsault. That mistake may cost Tajiri.
Referee Mike Sparks begins the count, but does Kidman have anything left?
That's the big question. He's got to pull it together, and he's got to pull it together quick. If Tajiri has any chance to catch his win, he's going to put Billy Kidman in a bad way.
This may be the opening Kidman needs. Oh. Kidman with a right hand. Tajiri exchanging blows with his opponent. Right hands by Kidman. Fire. carried away on the Japanese buzzsaw. Tajiri into the corner. Kidman up the ropes. What a clothesline. Here's the cover. Hook of the leg. Got him, no. Tajiri just got the shoulder up.
Kidman favoring that arm. Holding it up.
Talk about velocity. This match has been all velocity as we kick off this brand new show tonight. Tajiri buries Kidman. Could be in. Cover. Two. And Kidman again with the shoulder up.
What keeps Billy Kidman going?
Well, Tajiri says not much now because this one's over. And Kidman trying to battle with the elbows to the side of the head. Tajiri up over the top, lands on his feet.
Oh, goes for the Hurricanrana.
Oh, and Kidman countered. Here's the cover on Tajiri. Two, and Tajiri gets the shoulder up.
These cruiserweights want it so bad. They work from underneath. They push themselves even harder because they have to prove themselves that much more.
Yeah, Mr. McMahon, SmackDown giving this cruiserweight division an opportunity to shine, and two of the brightest stars in the division. And wow, what a kick. Hook of the leg by Tajiri. And Kidman again. Again, Kidman got the shoulder up.
Talk about heart.
How the hell is he doing this?
And look at him. He's fighting with a handicap after Tajiri has spent all that time on that arm. It's practically useless.
I think Tajiri is beginning to get a little frustrated, Al. Tajiri off the ropes. Oh, and what a drop kick! What a counter by Billy Kidman! I've never seen anyone do that to Tajiri before.
Well scouted by Kidman. Can he take advantage of it now?
Well, these two individuals know each other so well, Al. They've been in many battles over the years, as you mentioned. Now a shot to the kidneys. And Tajiri up over the top. And, oh, here we go.
Tarantula.
It's locked in. It is not a legal hold. He has to break the hold within five or he'll be disqualified.
You're absolutely correct. It's not a legal hold, but he still does the damage.
Wait a minute. Oh, there it. What a vision of beauty. That's Torrey Wilson. And Billy Kidman rolls Tajiri out, who just kicks out. Tajiri's ex-girlfriend, Torrey, obviously is distracted the Japanese buzzsaw.
Too.
And Torrey grabbed Tajiri's leg.
Why don't you come over and grab mine?
Oh, face first goes Tajiri. Kidman off the cover. He got him. Billy Kidman wins. Torrey cost Tajiri the matchup.
Billy Kidman.
Could she come down for every match?
What a match on velocity. Torrey just stuck it to her. Her ex-boyfriend Tajiri. And Billy Kidman, I guarantee you, he's going to have a cruiserweight title shot down the road after that win.
Wow, he owes her a big one.
Wow. You think that's something? Wait till later on tonight. Trish, Stacy, bra and panties for the women's title.
Oh, gosh. Michael, without a doubt, this has got to be my favorite kind of title match. Who wins? Who cares? Because we all win as long as somebody loses a shirt and a pair of pants.
Coming up next, Al, about Stacy and Trish. Coming up tonight, bra and panties for the women's title.
I'm going to worry about that, too.
How do you like me now?
Hey, Mean Gene is back, Confidential. Coming up next here on TNN. Brand new, right after Velocity. Yeah, how do you like me now?
I don't like you at all.
The following contest is scheduled for one ball. Approaching the ring from Mobile, Alabama, weighing in at 234 pounds, Hardcore Holly.
Well, one of the trainers from Tough Enough 2, Hardcore Holly, set for action at Tough Enough 2 finale coming up this week. We'll talk all about it.
Well, Michael, this week on my list of things you need to know, WWE Velocity is brought to you by 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect call.
And by Starburst Fruit Chews, Isn't Life Juicy?
And by the new Castrol GTX High Mileage. And you're right, Tough Enough 2, the finale coming up next week.
And from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 244 pounds, the Big Valbowski.
I give the Big Valbowski a hell of a lot of credit. It was a couple of weeks ago at Lance Storm and Hardcore Holly were involved in a brutal two-on-one attack of the rookie Randy Orton for no reason at all, except the fact that Hardcore Holly can't beat Orton in the ring. This two-on-one attack ensued, and well, Valbowski came out to help Orton out and even the odds.
And now I think Valbowski's going to make got to pay the price a little bit for helping Randy Orton out. You don't cross Bob Holly without having something come back.
So the Valbowski, Big Valbowski and Hardcore Holly lock up center of the ring to start this matchup on what has already been an exciting night on Velocity. Tell you, two men who really know how to get it done in the ring. Hardcore Holly, Big Valbowski have held numerous titles here in WWE.
Yeah, Valbowski been around the world. Hardcore Holly, too. Years of experience on both these guys' parts.
Well, Hardcore Holly lending that experience to all the kids in Tough Enough 2 this season. The finale Thursday night on MTV, immediately following SmackDown. Two of the four remaining kids will have an opportunity to become WWE superstars. Two contracts will be rewarded live on MTV on Thursday night. I'll tell you, it has been a very interesting couple of months for Tough Enough 2, Al.
You know what's great about Tough Enough 2?
I saw William Regal delivering chops like that on Tough Enough 2 this past week.
Well, it's great for the fans, especially the WWE, to watch the Tough Enough 2.
Wow, what a suplex by Valbowski into the cover. And Hardcore kicks out. You're not going to beat Hardcore Holly that quickly and without hooking the leg.
Hell no, you're not.
But it's been an emotional couple of months as well on Tough Enough 2. We saw Hardcore Holly react with a lot of emotion.
Well, that's what I was going to point out, is it's great for the fans because they get to see their favorite WWE superstars in a completely different fashion. They get to see the real person and see real emotions.
You know, speaking of emotions, what about this past week? Very difficult week. Annie and Pete eliminated off the cover. Valbowski gets the shoulder up. Annie and Pete eliminated this week on Tough Enough 2, Alan. That was an extremely emotional time for yourself.
Yes, definitely. That's going to be the toughest. He's singing in tenor.
And Hardcore follows it up with a clothesline.
Got a little wood on the ball on that one.
The rough and tough Hardcore Holly in control of the Big Valbowski.
Well, I was going to say, it's never easy to...
Suplex into the cover goes Hardcore. Hooks the leg this time, and Valbowski gets the shoulder up.
Walk up and tell a young guy or a young girl that basically their dream is over, that they're getting cut. And it's even harder, you get close to them over those few weeks, and then to walk up and tell them it too. It's tough, not really hard.
Valbowski into the corner, follows up with an elbow to the side of the head of Hardcore Holly. And there's another clothesline by Hardcore. So folks, we are down to four and Tough Enough Two. Two of these kids will be superstars come next week. Cover by Valbowski. A lackadaisical cover. I don't know how much Valbowski has left as Hardcore gets the shoulder up. So we're down to Kenny, Jake, Linda, and Jackie.
That's right. We'll see who can be the next WWE superstar. And I think everybody has seen Maven and knows exactly that that is exactly what they'll become.
Well, I'll tell you what, you know, Maven, not only is he a superstar, but now he's dating Tori.
My boy does the crowd.
And of course, folks, applications are underway for Tough Enough 3. Go to toughenough.com for more details. Whipped off the rope, Hardcore Holly, big back body drop by the Big Valbowski.
Tell everybody out there, if you've got the dream and you've got the guts, go for the glory.
Oh, look at this, setting up Hardcore, Fisherman Suplex. The bridge, and a kick out, got the shoulder up for Hardcore Holly.
Hardcore belly getting out of that. Boy, these guys are pushing it to the limit. This is a very physical match.
Look out! Hardcore, here's the cover by Valbowski. And Hardcore just gets the shoulder up. And this is going to be the important part of this Velocity showout. A chance for superstars in the SmackDown brand to show what they're made of right here in the WWE.
And that's exactly what these two are doing.
Oh, roll up by Hardcore. Valbowski kicks out after two. Spybuster. And Valbowski saying he's going up top.
Don't waste time. Don't play around. You're in there with Hardcore Holly. You can't avoid. You can't make a mistake like that.
Big Valbowski second rope. Hardcore Holly in all kinds of trouble. Oh, and he went for the big money shot. Halfway across the ring. Nobody home. And there's that drop kick under the chin. Hardcore into the cover. Hook to the leg. He's got it. And he defeats the Valbowski with the best drop kick in the business.
And that's exactly why it's the best. Because it's on the button every time.
Big Valbowski.
And stay tuned. Yes, the bra and panties match between Trish and Stacy is still to come.
But up next, he made this match coming up next. It's the bra and panties match for the the WWE Women's Championship. All Stacy has to do is take off Trish's clothes, and she'll be the next champion. And we'll all be rewarded.
Yeah.
We are back on Velocity, and we're about to see some legs and a whole hell of a lot more.
I can only hope.
Following contest is a pride and panties match for the WWE Women's Championship. In the ring, the challenger, Stacy Keibler.
Well, Michael, Snickers Cruncher presents WWE King of the Ring. Hungry? Crunch this.
Well, Taz and I had the opportunity to have Stacy dance at her announce table Thursday night on SmackDown. Tori a couple of weeks ago. I kind of like it being out there.
And I'm going to get up and petition because it's your, they're dancing on your table. Why aren't they out here right now dancing on mine?
Trish defeating Stacy. WWE Judgment Day with the women's title on the line. This is a rematch, and Mr. McMahon is really, I think, stacked the deck against Trish in this matchup.
All I can say is God bless Mr. McMahon.
We all realize that Stacy isn't an accomplished in-ring wrestler like Trish Stratus is. So what does Mr. McMahon do for his personal assistant? Well, he puts her into a bra and panties type matchup. Stacy doesn't have to use any wrestling hold. She can do that. Attack her opponent from behind, because all Stacy has to do to win the title is, well, take off Trish's pants and well, sure.
Well, I'm sorry. Wouldn't that be more in Trish's favor? Because I've heard that anybody can take Stacy's pants and trim off.
Well, Tess sure tried this past week on SmackDown. And look at the slam out of that
right
title. This past week on SmackDown, Tess, too, who has immunity and can't be fired, gave Stacy long kiss, I guess you would say.
Pretty long and pretty toothy.
It was a very interesting Thursday night on SmackDown for Tess. Not only the kiss to Stacy, but Tess cleaned Randy Orton's clock for Mr. McMahon. And for some unexplained reason, Tess, he attacked Triple H backstage. Like to know what that is all about.
What was the motivation behind that?
Shots with the elbow from Trish to Stacy. Oh, again, the women's title's on the line. And again, well, the rules are pretty simple, Al.
Girls, that is not what's on your chest. You don't use them for that.
And the bra and panties match is won when you strip your opponent down to her bra and panties. Right now, Stacy is halfway there.
Oh, yes, she is. And so am I.
And Stacy takes the pants of Trish off. And, well, there goes Stacy's top. Folks, as JR would say, business is picking up.
That's the right phrase. Business is definitely picking up.
Trish Stratus ripped across the ring. Stacy with a shot to the mouth of Trish.
A beautiful kick.
And there's a slap. I think Stacy should be trying to take the pants of Trish off instead of slapping her.
I couldn't agree more. I think she should do.
Well, I think here we go. The champion's in trouble. Yeah. And Trish reversed it.
Say it again. God bless Mr. McMahon.
And still, WWE Women's Champion, Trish.
Hey, I don't always agree with everything Mr. McMahon does, but look at this. A shot to the back of the head. Stacy will someday learn her lesson. I don't always agree with what Mr. McMahon does, but, well, he did do this for the fans. Check out the end of this matchup. All you got to do is stare. Words cannot describe what we just saw here on Velocity. Well, folks, what a great way to